Well, what do we have here? It's a Dallas18B20. It's another temperature sensor. It's one of the most common temperature sensors you will encounter. You probably will find two versions of this sensor. This small component one that you can easily solder on your PCB. And this encapsulated waterproof version. Both are identical, but let's work with this one today. The sensor has three pins and works with a one wire bus. Left pin is a ground pin. In the middle, we have the data pin. And on the right side, we have the VCC pin. And the sensor works from 3 to 5 volts. And since this works with a one wire bus, we need a resistor between VCC and the data line. Of 4.7 kilo ohms. Pretty easy, isn't it? So hooking this up will be pretty easy. We have ground to ground. Data line to digital 2. VCC to 5 or 3.3 volts. Let's take 5 volts. Yep. And our 4.7 kilo ohm resistor between the data pin and VCC. Well, that was quick. Since this is a very common and popular sensor, you can find the library, of course, in the library manager for the Della sensor. After installing it, we look for our examples. So let's check the examples. There, Dallas temperature sensor. Simple sketch. As we can see, choosing digital pin 2 is always a good choice. The sketch is quite simple. We only need to upload it and test it. So uploading it to our Arduino Nano and open the serial monitor. And we're getting our values. We are at 21.2 degrees Celsius. Let's validate it. Yeah, it's quite accurate. But what will happen if you remove this pull-up resistor? Without this pull-up resistor, you won't be able to request the temperature in a high frequency. Let's test it. Okay, we remove the resistor, open the serial monitor, and oh, it won't work after all. Temperature is minus 127. I guess that's not correct. I tested if I can connect the resistor back on live. Ooh, it seemed to work. And again, a cheap and useful temperature sensor. You get the small one for less than 1 euro each, and the temperature sensor that is encapsulated, I paid a little more than 1 euro. The only disadvantage is that you only can measure temperature with it. Compared to the DHT22 that can measure temperature and humidity, or the BMP 280 that can measure temperature and air pressure. But since those are small and quite handy, and this waterproof sensor is a quite good choice for outdoor use, I think it's a good choice to use. And since this little fella is often included in Arduino starter kits, you may even already have one of those. Bye.